Good afternoon. Welcome back to the Homeless World Cup. We're on pitch one here in George Square in Glasgow. And next up in the men's competition, it is India against Chile. Chile, side in the men's and the women's, it may well be dark horses, ranked fourth coming into the tournament. Alex Leithhead alongside me.
Could
be a good chance to see a side in Chile that, you know, are impressing one or two.
Absolutely. I mean, they've been fantastic to watch throughout the tournament. India have got a lot of spirit, but I think Chile have probably just got the edge in terms of ability.
Well, almost ready to go first on India in the blue. And India got through into the stage in Group C, level on points with Portugal. So they're in this at the moment, and looking to maybe cause a slight upset, because you can see Chile are the favourites, as many have liked their sides, men's and women's, like Mexico in that camp as well. We're often underrated. See India in their blue with Soen Durv, the captain, involved for their side. Chile with Lepe in there, Felipe Lepe, also Mateus Vilecic and Nicolas Munoz. And an early shot at goal there from Vilecic in there for Chile. And off to a good start possessionally. Lepe now to Vilecic again, and the keeper just parries it, but manages to keep a hold of it for India, Shahzad Mohammed.
Yeah, it's interesting. If you look at the body language of Mateus Vilecic there, he's just, he's got himself set. He's waiting for the ball, and you feel as soon as he's got the ball, he's going to, if he can, try and pull the trigger and score a goal.
All possession in this first minute or so with Chile, and having a whole discussion with tactics, and oh, that's rather neat. Not seen that one yet. Switching over the wings while in possession. Trying to get a shot away, but it's been lost out by Vilecic, and a little snap effort from Malarasaren, who's taking the strike.
Yeah, that little switch there from the Chileans was quite fun to watch, but would have been better if it did it in a goal, I think.
Yeah, it kind of seemed to confuse them. I think it confused everyone, and it confused themselves, because they lost possession straight after it. India looking to have a goal from distance. So Andurv, the captain, with that. Pretty end-to-end start. And that would have been some finish. Felipe Lepe with a long ranger. Again, back to this possessional play for Chile. Nice fourth coming in to this year's tournament. The seventh last year in Amsterdam. This men's side, obviously different players, as you know, playing one tournament, and decent little effort from Malarasaren. Back with Lepe for Chile. Looking for the opening goal still. Almost 3 minutes played.
So if you're coming into George Square, plenty of seats at all the stadiums.
Yes, it's a lot different from the previous match we've just seen here on pitch one, isn't it, Callum, where we had, I think, was it four goals within the first 2.5 minutes?
Yeah, and a unique aspect, really. You don't see too many nil-nils after a few minutes. With goals usually expected, and sometimes this tight affair is something different to watch. And Chile are definitely employing a few tactics, switching around their players. Came off the Indian number 7, Durv, the captain, almost could have went in the back of his own net from Munoz. He's trying to play it across, and here he is, Munoz, the number 3 for Chile. It's a good little hit, a good little try. Back though with the Indian keeper, Durv helping out Mohammed, and Mohammed having to the full stretch there. Goalkeeper's ball, mate, so that wasn't a goal, if you're wondering. And India, not a lot of ball, but they're hanging in there, aren't they?
They certainly are. They need to get out of their own half. It's Chileans are just camped on the doorstep, and there we have it. There's the goal that's been coming for the last few minutes.
Felipe Lepe with a wonderful finish to give Chile the lead, and it has been coming, as we say. India have held off and held off, but it has taken 4 minutes for the opening goal of this contest here on pitch one in George Square. Obviously, on pitch two, it's Northern Ireland against the Republic of Ireland, that one. It's got commentary, you can watch that one. You can watch all pitches on a live coverage.
That goal, though, does seem to have unlocked something in the Indians. They seem to be playing with a lot more urgency than they were to that point, but they've just gone another goal down.
Yeah, Felipe Alfaro has came on and gotten the scoring sheet, and now they're ramping it up. And Felipe Lepe looking for his second, and Chile's third, and may well be just the key that they found to open the door. Chile, two goals now, and they're very much in hunt for a third. They've upped the pace a little bit as well, but now here's a potential break. But the referee's pulled it back before Lungan Thung could take it on and break for India. So it is the free kick for Chile. Faro and linking up with Lepe, and again, not too far. I mean, another opportunity.
Yeah, I think that was just a slip rather than a sliding tackle. Sliding tackles are obviously banned in this tournament. And that's one thing to say about the quality of the refereeing that we've had. We've spoken to a few referees up here in the commentary box this week, and hopefully we'll do so again. But the quality of the refereeing has been absolutely superb.
Oh, he did so well there, did Mateusz Wilczys. He got the keeper on his backside and just couldn't quite finish it, hit off the woodwork of the crossbar. That would have been a rather clever goal if that went in. And that's rather late from Anthony. There is a blue card, obviously, which is a 2 minute sin bin. And well, I think it's been a couple of days since we've seen one settling on this pitch. And well, it's rare, but it's a 2 minute sin bin effectively. And it does mean that the rule where one player has to be in opposite half is cancelled out for that couple of minutes. But it is a big advantage now because it's 3-2. Chile have got 40 seconds left of this first half, and a lot of it the second with the advantage. And now trying to play quickly, Alfaro and Lepe flicking up, and it's only up to the other end. And this is now even more of a defensive job needed for India when they're needing goals.
Yeah, being reduced in numbers is the last thing that India needed right now. They were playing as if they were a man down on the pitch anyway, and the numerical advantages for Chile is surely going to turn into more goals.
Oh, and it came through, and somehow it's not went in. The original effort went through the keeper, Alfaro with it. Somehow the follow-up wasn't there, and that could well have been three. And a little effort and goal from Derv. He's trying his best, the captain. A man light, and there will still be a man light for a few seconds, probably 30 seconds, 40 seconds of the second period, but that is half-time now. And well, India hanging on is the expression I would use, cliched or not, but they are hanging on, aren't they, Alex?
Absolutely. They're 2-0 down. They could very easily turn this around in the second half, but you do feel that they're under more pressure than Chile are. Don't forget, they've also got the rest of the time in the sin bin for the player with the blue card. So Chile still have a chance to take advantage of the numerical supremacy.
And there is one of those goals from Felipe Alfaro. Felipe Lepe got the other one. And that's where we are at the moment. Chile, who the national partner for this is Football Cala. And while we have a little pause here at halftime, here is pitch two. We've got commentary on this game, and it's a really tasty game, and the crowd is big in that one as it is in pitch one. Republic of Ireland against Northern Ireland. And it just shows you, whatever pitch you're on, there's tasty games, Alex.
Absolutely. This is, I would say, one of the biggest games of the tournament. If you want to go and watch the action, they're two very, very competitive sides, very talented sides. The level of football from these two teams has been phenomenal throughout the week.
And if you are enjoying our affair in pitch one, you'll be able to watch this later on with YouTube coverage, of course. Do go into /homelessworldcup, and you can watch that game and all the others on our YouTube service. So back underway for this second half, and Chile on the front foot. India still down to two players with the blue card. It was about 40 seconds left in the first half, so there'll be a few seconds left in this half before India will be back up to three players. And a reminder, while they're at two players, outfield players on the pitch, that the rule where one player has to stay in the opposite half doesn't come into effect until they're back to three. So they've actually held out pretty well. Not going to tempt fate for the last few seconds, but they've held out well, India, with the two outfield players. Chile still looking to make things more comfortable for a third. And here is Lepe trying to instigate something. Gets it back. Lovely skill. All the way across, and was he in the box? It looked like his foot was in the box, and yes, it's been ruled out there. Matheus Vilches, and his feet were definitely in the orange. He's protesting, but it was a right call.
Absolutely. As I say, the quality of the refereeing has been spot on this week, and that's just another example of how accurate they've been.
Chile still with it. Vilches, and across it goes the box by Lepe. Now there's a break here. Oh, and not quite by Marisaren. Oh, that was a good chance, big chance for India. They don't get too many chances in this game, the way it's been playing. Back with Chile now, but is that the moment to reduce the arrears? Good feet by Lepe, once more, giving away. Here they come, lovely stuff again. Marisaren put his hand down at the floor, and he knows another good chance. India not getting too many in the game.
He just didn't have quite enough space there. I think if he had another foot, 2 foot to play with, he might have just been able to get the ball in the back of the net there.
Wonderful save by the Indian goalkeeper, Mohammed. Well, still only two goals in the two sides. Chile have not put this one to bed. Vilches now, and Lepe. Vilches in space. Keeper comes out to make himself look big. Lepe once more, looking for it back. Vilches this time, and that is the third goal, and that may well be, despite the time left, the way India have had very few chances in the game, a decisive goal.
Absolutely, and very, very clinical as well. You just don't feel that India are realistically going to get back into this.
Well, they'll try as they may. Durf gets it back, and that's an excellent little drill finish. And well, maybe there's still a small bit of hope, because it's back to two goals between the two sides.
I think that's what they call the curse of the commentator, Callum. As soon as they say, I don't think there's a way back in, they score a goal.
I predicted a South Korea win early in the earlier games, and they got beat, so I've stopped predicting things. But here comes Chile once more with Alfaro. We're going to play it across and back with Indian keeper Mohammed, looking to play long. That's out in the crowd, and the crowd continue to filter in with the two Scotland games ahead, men and women, on pitch one. Lunchtime as well too, so that helps with those that are maybe sneaking out on their lunch break from work. But there's a penalty here, and the goalkeeper picked it up, passed back, and chance here for Chile to finish off once and for all, and it's off the post from Felipe Lepe, and they can't put this one away. And now here's a chance for India again, and on the break was the captain Durf who scored their goal, and they're still sniffing a chance if they can get another opportunity, get it to 3-2. Now the crowd are getting a great game here, because Chile can't just put this away.
And just to bring you an update from the Ireland v Northern Ireland game on pitch two, it is now 1-1. They are level.
Cracking games all round. Remember, that one is on pitch two. You can watch that on our live coverage, or check out the action on our YouTube account later, /homelessworldcup. Oh, that's a fabulous little hit, and there is the goal. But it's not going to count, is it? The referee wasn't ready, and it was a great effort if it counted. Hossein thought he'd scored. Chile looking to finish it off. Munoz, who's back on the pitch.
Yeah, you do feel that if India are going to salvage anything from this game, they have to score the next goal. It's unfortunate for them that they had the ball in the back of the net and it doesn't count. But if they score another goal, they have the chance to equalise, and then obviously the match goes to penalties and then it's anybody's game.
And another thing, just to, you know, be impressed with India, is they had the 2-minute spell with the blue card player Sunbind, and they didn't concede through that period, which was impressive. But space once more for Chile, just can't finish off, but the ball is going to kindly fall back to their keeper. Vilches, and I guess time is ticking down, so they can go pretty slowly. They know they've still got a cushion. It's a tactical thing, but now they've lost it. Hussain was looking for support in Durf. Couldn't quite link up. Shot there from Vilches. And they're scrapping their way. Time running out, though. Under a minute left in this game. On pitch one. Oh, another chance just off the side of the advertising hoarding from Alfaro. And this time the net from Vilches. And maybe one thing for later in the tournament, Chile, a lot of ball, but they've spurned a lot of chances. And now Hussain, post again. Just not going to happen for India, and that will finish things off once and for all for Chile. Nicolas Munoz, and 4-1 the scoreline, and they've had plenty of play, plenty of chances. Finally, they've taken one just to clinch it.
Yes, India have created the chances, but those chances have come too late, and it was just not enough time to bring this game around. And now with 4-1, they're going to go back in. I don't think the scoreline necessarily reflects the performances overall, but you do feel that the Chile were just the stronger side.
Yes, they've had plenty of ball, and they've finally got themselves over the line. Maybe looking to finish things off with a fifth goal. Can India score? Not quite from Malasarin, and there we are, India 1, Chile 4, and well, 4-1 on the scoreboard, but in general, a really entertaining game, Alex.
Indeed, very, very entertaining game. As you say, India did well to keep the scoreline the same when they were down to two outfield players, but in the end, Chile were just too strong for them.
Remember, part of the Homeless World Cup, you can donate Tet's goal to 70660, it costs £5. And it'd be great to get your donations. And remember, our coverage on YouTube, you can watch this game again if you enjoyed it shortly. And here is one of the moments of the game. And India played their part, scored the one goal, the captain got it, and Durv, and I say a lot of respect because they did hang in there. And that was a good moment for them. Remember, you can watch the last few seconds of the Republic of Ireland Northern Ireland game. No, well, the last few minutes are still about 4 or 5 minutes or so on that one. Remember, that's on pitch two. Do watch that in our coverage. Republic of Ireland 4, Northern Ireland 3.
Indeed, we have it there. It looks like an absolute thriller of a match. You feel that with such a tight scoreline, the way that both teams have been playing throughout the week, that anything can still happen. I wish I could be down there myself right now in the sunshine watching it like the crowds. And if you don't forget, you can go online, watch it live on Eversport, the live streaming partner. See it on YouTube and Facebook, and also on Unilad.
So you can check that out. You can watch that game and all the others on YouTube. /Homeless World Cup, all that's on there. Remember, interact on Twitter and Facebook. But coming up, we've got two Scotland games. We're getting the crowd ready, but coming up in a few minutes' time, it's Scotland's men against Romania. Join us in a couple of minutes.